So for the past few weeks, I've been posting a lot of videos on like cool, helpful tips about nutrition, eating, sleep, exercising. But I also want to let you know that you can actually do a lot to optimize your health in the workplace. That's like a secret skill, secret sauce that I don't think a lot of people really realize has got to be really beneficial for them. And the biggest thing is activity. So you could actually burn calories at work. So the first thing I would say is to stand more. On average, I want you to think about how many hours of sitting that you're doing throughout the day. Like, just think about it. Count how many times that you got up today. We're sitting for so long, and our body is in a position that's not natural. Our body's natural position is actually to be standing up. So you see all those anatomy books where the guy's like this? Sitting down is not an optimal position for our body to be in. And what will happen is your body's gotta get used to being in that flexed position, and it's not gonna want to be loose and fluid. So when you're working out, you're gonna be working on very tight, sore muscles, and that's not good. So you gotta stand more. So how can you stand more? There's gonna be three ways that you can stand more. Pick and choose whichever one works for you. These are what has been working for me, or a few ideas that kind of came up that I thought would be extremely helpful. For the first one would be honestly just standing at work. So standing every 30 to 40 minutes, what I try to do is I stand up and I stretch. And that could be anything from lifting your hands over your head, twisting, doing all that jazz. But the main idea is just to stand up every 50 minutes. What I love, if you have an Apple Watch, which I know many of you probably do, or a Fitbit, it reminds you to stand up every hour anyway. So go ahead, stand up for about five minutes just to stretch, stand up, get your body into the most optimal position. The second thing I would say is during meetings, I actually don't mind if I stand up. So when you're in a meeting, everybody's sitting in a circle or talking, and sometimes there's always that one person that comes in late that doesn't get a seat. I'm always the person to give up my seat because I'm like, I sit all day. I don't mind standing. I don't mind giving that 20, 30 minutes of just standing up. Ooh, that's a huge beat. That was a huge beat. So standing up in meetings is a good idea. I know it might seem awkward, but you might end up encouraging your coworkers to be standing up as well. And then the last and final way, and the reason why I save this to last because it is a little expensive, is seeing if your company can sponsor you getting a standing desk, right? These are one of the desks that you can actually elevate when you're standing, and you can actually operate with the keyboard and the mouse on top of it. I wish I could have it on mine, but the way that my desk is set up, I can't actually do it. So I actually do something a little bit more makeshift. I just take an empty box, I put my keyboard on top of it, and I put a mouse, and I just use it, and it's my makeshift and free desk. But see if your company can sponsor it, and if your desk can fit it, I would definitely recommend. So remember guys, stand more. So now we're gonna do step it up to level two. Moving more and walking more. We already have all these fitness trackers and these research saying that we need to take 10,000 steps a day. I actually want you to be taking 12,000 steps. So you gotta move more, right? You gotta move more throughout the workday. How are you gonna do it? So one of the biggest things that I do to get more steps in is once I stand up to stretch and I get that notification on my Apple Watch, I like to take a lap around the office, right? And it serves two purposes. So not only are you getting your steps in and you're burning more calories while you're walking, but you're also giving yourself the opportunity to meet the other people on your floor. Something that's been a big craze to me. There's sometimes you could be on the floor with somebody for 2 or 3 years and not know who that person is. So by you walking, you're burning calories and you're meeting new people, which you never know who that person might be that can help benefit your career in the long run. Claim. So the second thing I do is, and this is pretty cool because I kind of make it a little bit of a game, and what this is I tell myself, in order to get from floor to floor today, you can't use any type of mechanical equipment. So what does that mean? It means you're gonna be taking the stairs, and the reason why I love the stairs, and if you've ever done the Stairmaster at the gym, you totally understand why, but you're gonna basically be building a great set of legs because you're gonna be developing the quad area, but then you're also getting more cardio in because walking upstairs is actually a little bit more strenuous on the body in a good way than walking in a regular, normal straight line. So if you have stairs, then in fact, no, not if you do have stairs because there's a fire stairwell. So take your stairs. Maybe it's that you just go up one or two floors and then you take the elevator. The whole idea is just to take the stairs more, burn more calories throughout the day. And then finally, the last thing, and this is something that maybe might be more of a team buy-in, is see if you could take walk and talk meetings, right? These are great because You guys get to get up, maybe you get to walk outside and talk about whatever project that you have to work on or a deadline that's due. And it's a great way to, one, get some air if you want to walk outside, and then two, again, you're walking around the office with each other. It probably spurs more creativity. So just try to add more steps throughout the day. I would do those three things: walk around the office, you know, try to take the stairs a lot more, and then three, just try to take walk and talk meetings, and you'll be surprised at how many steps you get at the end of the day. And remember, you want to go for 12,000. So I hope this video was helpful for you. Please share it with a friend or a coworker, somebody that you know this will help, and spread the message that you could still be active and healthy, even in a busy work environment, and you got this, all right? I'll catch y'all next time.